What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Joe Cobra YouTube channel. I hope everyone is doing great out there. Today I'm going to be bringing you a retro flashback, this time of another classic of mine, and that is Kickboxer. Kickboxer was released in 1989 and is produced and directed by Marc Dessau and also co-directed by David Wirth. The film stars Jean-Claude Van Damme, Dennis Alexio, Michael Kissy, Dennis Chan and Haskell V. Anderson. So, Kickboxer tells the story of Kurt Sloan, who is played by Jean-Claude Van Damme, who is the cornerman for his brother, American kickboxing champion Eric Sloan, who is played by real-life kickboxing champion Dennis Alexio. When Kurt witnesses his brother become horribly paralyzed in the ring by Thailand's champion Tung Po, Kurt vows to take revenge. With the help of Xian Chao, played by Dennis Chan, a legendary kickboxing trainer who lives in a remote area of Thailand, Kurt then begins training for the fight of his life. The film begins after another successful US title defense for Eric Sloan, who after the fight is enticed by the media to compete in Thailand, where kickboxing originated. To further establish his legacy, Eric and Kurt then travel to Bangkok to fight Tung Po, who is Thailand's undefeated top fighter, played viciously by Michael Kissy. Eric is supremely confident, but Kurt is apprehensive, particularly after witnessing Tung Po kicking the shit out of a concrete pillar to prepare for the fight. Kurt begs his brother not to fight, but Eric dismisses any concerns, reminding his little brother of who the real champ is. The first round of the fight is a one-sided affair in which Tung Po dominates Eric with his superior strength and skill. In between rounds, Kurt once again begs Eric to stop, but Eric refuses to give up and gets beaten badly in the second round. Kurt throws in the towel, but Tung Po kicks the towel out of the ring and continues his assault. He viciously strikes Eric in the back with his elbow, immobilizing him, then rips apart Eric's World Championship belt. Kurt retrieves the belt and leaves with his brother on a stretcher, but the fight officials leave them on the street and locked out of the arena. It is here where we then meet Winston Taylor, a retired US Army Special Forces member played by Haskell V. Anderson, who reluctantly agrees to help the pair and drives them to the hospital. As a result of Tung Po's brutal assault, we find out that Eric is paralyzed from the waist down and will never be able to walk, let alone fight again. A furious Kurt then vows to avenge his brother and defeat Tung Po.
I'm sorry. There's nothing more I can do. Your brother is paralyzed.
What do you mean, paralyzed?
Spinal cord was damaged around the 10th vertebrae. I'm afraid he can never walk again.
You're going to make him walk again.
You're going to make him walk again.
Easy,
walk again.
Easy, yeah, okay, okay, easy.
He's going to make
take
him
it
walk
easy.
Again.
Take
he's
it easy. Take it easy.
Easy.
It's fortunate, even to survive, he'll be in hospital for at least 3 months before he can be moved. I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry. I'm sorry.
Forget about it. I'm not signing your death warrant too.
After leaving the hospital, Taylor tells Kurt about Jian Chow, a famous trainer living in a remote area in Thailand. After first bonding over some drinks, they then arrive at Jian's place and Taylor leaves and Kurt gets caught in a trap. And we meet Jian, where Kurt asks Jian to train him.
Here we are, my man. Shangri-La meets Alice in Wonderland.
What is this?
It's Xianland. I'm telling you, man, he's waiting in a three-headed cat.
Good luck. You're leaving?
Yeah, I got some business up the road. You're welcome to come along.
No, I'll take my chances here.
Well, I'll be back in a few hours. By the way, don't you provoke him, you hear?
Don't provoke him.
I help you?
Yes. Let me down.
No, I cannot.
Why?
Don't know who you are, what you want.
I want down. And I want you to teach me Muay Thai.
Really? But you are American.
So?
Americans have swelled heads, especially when hanging upside down for too long.
Very funny. Can you cut me down, please?
Heard about American champion last week. Oh, very swelled head. Lost badly in fight.
That was my brother. And now he cannot walk. Wait. Wait. Yo. Hey, wait.
So before they start, Xian first sends Kurt to the local village where he gets into a fight with some thugs from a criminal organization led by Freddie Lee, who is played by Karting Lee, who keeps harassing Mai Li, played by Rochelle Ashana, who happens to be Xian's niece. After returning to Xian, Mai Li tells her uncle what went down, and Xian, who is very happy to hear that Kurt can handle himself, then begins Kurt's extreme training. While Kurt is in training, him and Mai Li become close and start to fall for each other, and Xian begins to see Kurt's potential. Xian then decides to take Kurt to a bar where Freddie Lee and his goons hang out. Xian gets Kurt drunk to test him again to see if he can put what he has taught him to good use, and goes and whispers something to some of the goons in the bar, followed by one of the Van Damme's most famous scenes and one that cracks me up every time. With Kurt now ready, Xian sets him up with some professional kickboxing bouts, and Kurt wins all his fights with ease, all with Freddie Lee watching him from the stands. Xian then convinces Freddie to arrange a match between Kurt and Tung Po. It is then determined that they will fight the ancient way, where both fighters wrap their hands in hemp rope, which is then coated in resin and dipped in broken glass to make them deadly weapons. When they return home, we see Eric, who is now out of hospital, waiting for them, and finds out about the fight and becomes worried that his brother will suffer the same fate, if not worse, and tells him not to fight Tung Po. But just like Eric did, Kurt refuses to listen and begins his final training. We then see Freddie Lee, who arranges to have the fight fixed and borrows up $1 million from the crime syndicate's boss to bet on Tung Po. Several days prior to the match, Mai Li is beaten and raped by Tung Po, while Eric is kidnapped so that Freddie Lee can blackmail Kurt into losing the fight. To save his brother's life, Kurt is instructed by Freddie Lee to go the distance with Tung Po before losing the match. So the fight starts and Kurt takes a torturous beating, but while the fight is taking place, Xian and Taylor go all commando and successfully rescue Eric before the fight concludes. Just before the final round, we see Eric, who whistles from the crowd and gives Kurt the thumbs up while leading the crowd to chant Nok Su Kao, which means white warrior. Eric now out of danger, Kurt begins to take his revenge and viciously beats Tung Po. Now guys, I can't end this retro flashback without mentioning the fantastic soundtrack from Paul Herzog, who also done the soundtrack for Bloodsport, another classic Van Damme film. And along with Stan Bush, who you hear singing in some of these tracks, they fitted both these films fantastically well and still give that sense of euphoria even when watched today. And as for Jean-Claude Van Damme, I'm a big fan of his films, and although his acting, we all know, can be a bit hammy, you can never doubt what Van Damme brings to the table when it comes to action movies. And Kickboxer, along with Bloodsport, are the films that finally put him on the Hollywood map and made him out to be the much-loved star that we know and love today. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this retro flashback of Kickboxer. Please leave down in the comments below what was your favourite Van Damme film. And also guys, if you like this content, please hit the subscribe button and also hit that bell button so you get notified when I post a video. And thank you again, guys, for watching. You guys take care of yourselves. Peace.